on the Legislative Council disqualification. No doubt at all, that's a prelude to national security law witch hunt. The Hong Kong-style election has never been a free and fair one since 2016, when candidates like Edward Leung, Nathan Law, Agnes Chow, and me were disqualified one by one from the election. Today, with their sweepingly arbitrary power, electoral officers have extended their political vetting also to my friend like Greene Po, Tiffany Yun, Lester Shum, and other pan-Democrats and even incumbents. Beyond any doubt, it's the most scandalous election fraud ever in Hong Kong history. Before going full Ms. Choi's witch hunt decision, I wish to emphasize that no reasonable man would think that this election ban is not politically driven. Beijing has staged multiple acts to prevent the opposition bloc from taking the majority in Hong Kong legislature. They could disqualify us, they could arrest us and throw us into jail. They could even call off the election and create a puppet parliament elsewhere just together with Beijing loyalists. However, none of this can overturn the strong mandate for more than 600,000 Hong Kongers who had cast their ballot, the city's first ever primaries early this month. Our voice is clear and loud to the world by our vote. We stand to defend our freedom and rights that's stipulated in the Joint Declaration and the Basic Law. Barring me from running the election would not stop our cause for democracy. Even though the government may soon declare democratic aspiration illegal under the new law. Excuses used to rule my nomination this time are proved invalid and ridiculous. Ms. Alice Choi, the returning officers of Kowloon East District, cite obstacle statements by Stemocisto and selectively frame them as my political belief, regardless of the fact that Stemocisto was disbanded a month ago and was not even promoting and advocating self-determination since January of this year. The government also said, by engaging in international exchange and advocacy work, I continue to solicit interference by foreign government in Hong Kong's internal affairs. Needless to say, opposing the national security law is framed as not supporting, promoting, and embracing the basic law. Voting against government proposal and bills enhancing police brutality is considered as paralyzing the government. Nonetheless, the government decision is far more than depriving my right to political participation. The 18 pages decision contains a lot of rhetoric allegations that could be used as offenses under the national security law. In particular, Ms. Choi cites my recent Facebook post on 10th of July, 10 days after the national security law was enforced, claiming that I have the intention to continue to solicit interference by foreign government. To make it clear, it was definitely a misrepresentation because the post was merely a commentary for two international news. I have to take steps to refute such false allegations. As we all know, national security law is actually a legal weapon used against dissidents. 2 days ago, Tony Jung and three other students were arrested on inciting secession for online speeches. The special judges who oversees national security law case are directly appointed by the city's loyalist, Carrie Lam. From making of evidence, arrest, prosecution and trial, the administration can control almost every procedure the law requires. If the scandalous operation of the government is tolerated and not refuted, I believe I would be given no chance of defense when I'm arrested, prosecuted by the National Security Bureau. Lastly, I wish to thank all voters who entrust my political belief and generously gave nomination to support my campaign. Our resistance continue on, and we hope the world can stand with us in the upcoming uphill battle. Even government censor me out from failure. They can't censor my qualification to commit in the democracy movement in Hong Kong. And that's the reason they can't kill us all. Even they try to prosecute us, bar us to run for office, and silence our voice, we wish to try our best lest our voice being heard around the world. From the evidence, or the 18 pages evidence provided by the electoral offices, it seems to be the evidence that they generated with misleading propaganda and interpretation to prosecute me soon with national security law. And we can't still predict how many candidates belong to the pro-democratic camp they wish to disqualify. But no matter what happened, I still have hope and trust on Hong Kong people. We will still find a way out. And I still hope to encourage international media not only paying attention to candidates just like me, also pay attention to Tony Jung and other activists who are still detained or locked up in prison with the national security law prosecution. So later on, I will reply a question in Chinese and English. So now